May 30th, 2016. This video is an internship instruction video to teach an intern how to do a diagnosis of a medical condition in a 5-year-old female terrapin that has come in about 2 weeks ago with an egg stuck in the cloaca. The terrapin could not eat and drink because the egg, the well-formed egg, was stuck inside the cloaca and could not come out. So the terrapin couldn't pee, couldn't poop, and there's a backflow, couldn't urinate also. So it came in for consultation at Toa Payoh Vets, and we can see the egg. So we puncture the egg with the syringe, suck out the contents, break the eggs, and then send the terrapin back after it starts to eat the next day. So the terrapin went home, and at that time there was no x-ray done of the egg in the cloaca because it was obvious. Then terrapin went home, and it was eating the next few days. After about a week, the owner came and said that this terrapin stopped eating for the next 4 days. So based on the history, what do you think is the cause of the problem? I'm asking the intern. Okay.
We will first conduct a physical examination, but we will look from the front to the back for any external injuries. Looking at the back, if you look at the cloaca, the cloaca opening is loose instead of being closed as it should be.
Well, let me see. Yes.
It is.
Can you see? Yeah, correct. Wait, let me see. Yeah, it's loose. Yeah, correct.
The opening is loose.
Okay. The vent. Okay, then. What next are you going to do? Physical
now,
examination. Yeah.
After physical examination is done, we'll go on to further lab tests. One, blood test. Second, urine test. Third, x-rays. And fourth, ultrasound.
Okay.
There are now 4 tentative differential diagnoses. First of which is based on the medical history, obstruction to the cloaca caused by eggs or foreign obstruction caused by stones in the aquarium. Second, it could also be due to infections due to dirty water. Third, it could be due to external injuries caused by fall, and that might injure his internal organs as well. Fourth, it could be due to tumours due to his old age at 5 years old.
5 years is not very old, but they live up to 30. Okay.
Okay.
Next.
Next. So based on his medical history of egg binding, we'll go on to conduct x-rays.
Okay, come, let's go and see the x-ray. Okay, come, let me see the x-ray. Where's the x-ray just now? No, this time the x-ray. On, just now the x-ray was on. Where is it? Okay, come. Okay, so the terrapin, wait, the x-ray, this is x-ray in a tank, because otherwise it will be running all over the place. Now we show that the terrapin is being x-rayed. There's a picture taken. Wait, now let me, so you can see he's enclosed in a plastic tank, so you couldn't run around, otherwise we wouldn't have a clear x-ray. So this is before x-ray, or before the x-ray beam is pressed. Okay, now we see the image now of the x-ray taken. Okay, so what do you see?
There are 50 stones and one eggshell as pointed by the arrow.
Yeah. Where is it in?
It's
in the cloaca.
Yeah, it's in the cloaca.
So you can see from this slide, it's the red ear slider female, 5 years. Just read the.
It's a red ear slider female, 5 years, and it has not been eating for the past 4 days. From this accurate image, there are 50 stones and one eggshell is pointed by the arrow obstructing the cloaca. Because of this, it cannot pee and poop.
And because of the obstruction, it becomes ill and then loses appetite. So what's the diagnosis?
Based on X-ray is the obstruction by the 50 stones and one eggshell.
No, the name of the diagnosis.
The name of the diagnosis.
It's all in green there.
Egg bite, cloacal infection.
Cloacal infection. So the diagnosis is confirmed by X-ray. Okay, so what's the treatment?
The treatment is to remove these stones and eggshell by using a forceps.
Okay.
After,
how do you remove? By cutting open?
Or
how?
We'll just use a forceps to internally remove the stones and eggshell from the cloaca.
Cloaca, yeah. To pick up the stones and to flush out the stones. Okay, now you can see the terrapin now. So the terrapin is hospitalized. Look outside there. Hospitalized. Judy, put the water in. Come. There, come. Put outside there now. Away from the other, just put here. Okay, then put the water in. Yeah. Slope a bit, slope. So the terrapin has been here for 3 days. Okay, after she... So now, we pour warm water, because terrapins can only eat when they have water, they cannot eat directly. So, get ready the food. No, let her put. And put the... Wait. Just put. Let her put. Put a bit first into the, no, let her do, just throw one a few, one or two first. Come nearer. In front of his face. See whether he's eating or not. Where's the thing you're supposed to put in? The nutrient pack. And calcium. He didn't prepare.
No.
Okay. So is he eating?
Yes.
So after 3 days hospitalization, you can see from here the terrapin is eating. So his appetite is very good. So put some more in. So this shows that he's no more sick. And 50 stones from the tank has been removed. And he's going home today. Anyone, just put one by one. Yeah. Now if you want to put medication, you're supposed to put it onto the pellets, and then the terrapin will eat the pellets together, the medication. Now this terrapin is used to eating pellets, so that's why you can see he's eating the pellets. Yeah. So once the appetite is returned, it's back. So this terrapin goes home today. Now let him finish off. Actually, they can eat about 40 to 60 pellets. This terrapin is 5 years old female, has a very good appetite. And the pebbles have been taken out. So ask Judy for the pebbles. The stones. Judy, the stone and the egg. Stone and the egg. So evidence of removal of the stone and the egg. Put it against here, we can see. Okay. You can see the... Don't block it with your hands. No. I can't see clearly. This side. Come this side, against the light. Not very clear, but you can see... On the right is the eggshell. On the left are the 50 stones, which have been removed from the cloaca. And so the owner has been advised not to put any more small stones on the bottom of the aquarium tank, as this terrapin likes to swallow them. So the overall diagnosis is cloaca infection. And the treatment is extraction using forceps, and prevention is not to put any more pebbles or small stones in the aquarium. May 30th, 2016, Papaya Vets, Singapore.